For years on CGDIVE, I've been covering auto-rigging add-ons like Rigify, but recently I decided to make my own auto-rigging add-on. For now, I call it the CGDIVE Auto-Rig. It's still in early development, but in this video, I'll show you exactly how it works, and you can even get your hands on it right now. For now, you can get it completely free on my Gumroad. You'll find a link in the video description, so enter 0 here or a higher number if you want to support me. Then download the zip file and just drag and drop it into Blender. Once the add-on is installed, you can start using it under the CGD tab. At the top, you'll see feedback and tutorials. The first button will take you to a tutorial, and by using the second one, you'll be able to send me feedback about the add-on, which I would highly appreciate because the add-on is in early development, and if you notice a problem, I need to hear about it so that I can fix it. And then we have two ways to create armatures. One is a simple default human rig, and the second one is a more modular approach. In this video, I'll just give you a quick overview of each workflow. You can find more detailed step-by-step tutorials in your Gumroad downloads. The standard human workflow will give you a simple humanoid skeleton to start with. You can choose if you want it to have fingers or not. Then you just go ahead and align these bones to your character. If you have Rigify experience, it should feel familiar. For now, this rig is kind of hard-coded, so please do not rename or delete any of the bones. Only adjust their proportions in edit mode. If you need more freedom, then you can use the modular workflow, which I'll show you right after this one. Once the bones are in place, choose the number of twist bones you want to generate for arms and legs, and then press Generate. Congratulations, you now have a fully functioning human rig. You can bind your character to your new rig with automatic weights. If you want to paint weights, deformation bones are found under the DEF collection. The rig features IK-FK switching and FK isolation setups. You'll find the switches by selecting the cogwheel shape and going to the End Panel, Item, Properties. Now for the modular workflow. It allows you to build your skeleton part by part by adding spines, legs, arms, and so on. This way you can rig more unusual characters, you can give your bones custom names, and so on. You start by creating a new modular rig base, which contains a root and a settings bone. Then enable construct mode. Usually you first add a spine, and now to start adding modular parts, first, select a bone that you want the new module to be attached to. So here I select the last bone of the spine and add a new head module. This gives me a neck and a head exactly where I want them. On top of that, this process automatically parents the bones, so they will move together in pose mode. This is important for the generation process, which we'll do after adding all of the rig modules. Now I'll select the top spine bone again and add a shoulder, and then I'll add an arm to the shoulder. Next, I'll add a leg to the base of the spine and adjust it. Now I add fingers to the hand. And at this point, I symmetrize the rig because I need the exact same modules on the other side. Next, I'll add some so-called support bones. They are deformation bones which make our automatic weights better. Now I'll handle the unusual parts of the rig. I'll add another arm and fingers. And I also create custom bones for the breasts and a chain of bones for the ponytail. Custom bones need to be named and parented manually for now. These are all of the modules that I wanted. So now I can go to generate mode. In this mode, I have to select all bones of a module and then press the corresponding generate button. For example, here I select the 5 bones of the spine and click generate spine. Then I select the shoulder bone and click generate shoulder. And in the same way, I'll generate the head and so on. Each module needs to be generated individually in this early version of the add-on. This is already quite efficient, but I definitely plan to optimize the generation process in a future update.
Now the rig is complete, so just like with the standard human, I can parent my character to the rig. If you need the deformed bones, they'll be in the DEF collection. And you have IKFK and isolation switches for all limbs that you generated. So in this case, you'll have switches for 3 arms and 2 legs. Again, this was just a quick overview of the process. You'll find a more detailed step-by-step tutorial in the Gumroad files. The add-on is still in alpha and it does have some limitations and possibly some bugs. If you find any, please use the send feedback button and let me know what I need to fix. Probably the biggest limitation I'm aware of right now is the lack of regeneration features. You can generate the rig, but if you need to tweak it, then you either have to do it manually or you have to delete parts and create and generate them anew. Also, the spine can only be a chain of 5 bones right now, but I want to make it more flexible. So I'll be working on these in upcoming updates. My short-term goal is to keep improving the existing rig presets and also adding more common ones like animal legs, tails, and so on. I also enjoy working on the user experience aspect, which I think many add-ons neglect. Despite its current limitations, the add-on is out and I personally have a lot of fun using it. I hope you like it too. But what's next? I hope that is the exciting part for you. Since the add-on is new, you can help decide what it becomes. What kind of features would you like to see? What kind of features do you miss in existing solutions? Let me know in the comments below and subscribe with notifications if you want to get the latest news about the CGDIVE Auto-Rig.